work in the clinical, but I'm now more a researcher and very enthusiastic about my PhD. Yesterday, I was suddenly involved in a special curious situation in the airport of Stockholm. In a perfume shop, it was two ladies talked, an American and Swedish. And the American was very worried how she can come to Russia in those conditions. And Swedish said, yes, really, it's difficult to come to Russia for Americans now. And I was just nearby. And I thought, I have to say something. And I said to this Swedish lady, I'm sorry, but I don't think that it's easy for Swedish to come to Russia in those conditions than for Americans. I just said that. Because immediately the football team, Swedish, coming to Russia, football, immediately in some point of the game, it's always coming to side, Poltava, and Russians are growling Poltava. And she, Swedish lady, chose to pay. Maybe not because of Poltava, maybe because of the Vikings. But I said to her, if you were Vikings, Norwegians were Vikings as well, and it's never shouting against us. But Swedish Vikings, they ruled Ukraine, but not Russia. It was silence. And she said, it's easy for you because you are neighbors. And suddenly, maybe said I, but suddenly came a lady and she said, I'm from Ukraine, she said. And we are neighbors to Russia, it doesn't help. And it was silence, total silence in this perfume shop in Stockton yesterday. Until the Swedish again, she said, I know, because you are neighbors in the north. And I said, it's correct, it's a clue. We're not just neighbors in the north, but in the high north as well. So it's a clue, and we understand that high north and north are very important. Today I will share with you my experiences in doing business towards Russia in 20 years from the telecommunication sector and company, and we started from the north. And what forced us to that? It was 1993. And globalization came, and suddenly a little company from little country, they started to think, should we be Vikings, or how we will achieve the success in the big world? Because the Viking strategy is very clue strategy. Vikings, they put in the flag where they see the opportunities. Just flag, 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 and maybe we'll take something back to us. And the opportunities, they came in the north. Why? It was government protection, it was political, very good situation. Because we are neighbors, because it was more than 1,000 years of communication and lawyers, language and people knew people to people. It was not so dangerous to open big Russia through the little north. And because it's very simple. Never invest if your investment will ruin you. It was small money in the north, and Rune Harmsen said to me once, Irina, we can lose this money and we will not ruin talent. Okay, so we started in 1993 in Boris Corporation, and it was a success story. It was very good. Why? And what was challenging? Challenging work first. We had to have no experience in international work. Little country, little company. But what would happen? We started to build up stone by stone. But first, the flag was Vikings. Yes. After that, we understood that our micro world between us and our Russian partner doesn't mean a lot. This one don't have relationship to the micro world. In micro world, it's license from authorities, regulator, politicians, many things around. So the first was we had to build up relationship to the micro world with networking, and micro world with our partner. Number two, we understand that it should be in the start 50-50. We cannot just give us everything. Because of us as new ones. And we built up joint ventures as a structure. And it was very suitable because partners were professionals and we were professionals. And very we will understand that it's something we can share between us. Number three, it was very good, that the knowledge from telecommunication practice in Russia in those period was very low. And our partner wanted to get more and more know-how. So we started to build up some kind of networking of seminars, workshops. I could call to Vice President of Telecom Technology and say, tomorrow we'll take a flight to Hannover, but there will be a delegation from Russia and they need some information about how to build up this and this and this sector. Yes, and we did it. We invested in a lot of actions just to be a part of Russian telecommunication development. But at the same time, what were the challenges? The same macro world, because politicians couldn't understand the business rules, this was at the start of the 90s. Micro world, because partners totally was without any experience in business. The, everybody came from the Russian red director's positions. What happened, just took the license, put it in the pocket, and sit in there, nothing more. Number three, they always started to mix business and privacy. It's my family who comes with me to the business meeting and then my daughter and sorry, it's business. And when they ask us, do we really need the board of directors? Yes, you need. Do we really need the budgeting process? Yes, you need. Do we really need that we need some tender between supplies because I know that and I know that? Yes, you need. So actually, all our problems, they were connected to this magic word, governance. Because the Soviet Russia collapsed, the new Russia wasn't built up, they had no clue about the business governance, and we should to learn that. But don't think so good about us, because Norwegians were not so international as well. And many things that came after, and we learned Russians while we learned ourselves. And many things came with stock exchange experiences from New York, from the big global business. And governance, as it showed it, was a really the red line for success and critical to it. Because if you don't have the strict rules, you're out. And code of conduct, it should be and can be the marvelous tool how to explain why you really do business on that way. But Norwegians as well didn't understand the code of conduct. It's come very late as an experience. And when we started to think about the code of conduct, of course we worked inside in the company. And after that, we wanted to present it to Russians, to our partners. And sometimes in this period, with this yellow to smiles, we decided to reorganize our strategy because sometimes we don't have possibility to control if we have just 50-50. So we moved from joint venture to another constellation, like subsidiary with 100% ownership or more than 50% ownership. And then we came as owners and it came a terrible challenge. Where you don't have a control, you're saying, I don't have an influence. But when you do have a control and want to influence on governance, you should to force your partner to be as you. And that is the biggest challenge. And in the end of my presentation, I can tell you stories. Many of my colleagues heard the story. I love the story. Story from Russian book, from 1889. The dream, two boys meet each other. One boy with trousers on. Another boy without trousers. It's a dream. Boy with the trousers, he's German. And boy without trousers, he's Russian. And two boys started to talk about everything. Structure of society, habits, culture, and John oneself. I'm a good boy, and my parents love me, and I love them. And my teacher loved me, and I love him. All the rules that existing, I fulfill. I do that and that. I'm not stealing. I do my homework. It's clean around me. And I'm getting trousers for that. What about you, Russian boy? Why you don't have trousers? And the Russian boy said, I have just fun. I don't need promises. I have just fun. But how will life around you in Russia is organized? Asks a German boy. Everybody arguing. We have battles. It's dirty. We're stealing. It's bad. But we have fun. And they talk. We understand they're from different cultural worlds. Like in this case, investor and not coming to take the ruling of governance and rules in the company. Different worlds. And then, suddenly, in the end of the story, the bad battle, scandal came. Boys started to argue, and especially Russian was terrible angry because German said, Russian boy, you don't have trousers. I feel so pity and sorry about you. Be with me. Be loyal to me. You can hear the laws, you can do the homework, all rules, all laws, clean up, don't drink, you will get trousers. And the Russian boy, who actually was not so against this job, he was so angry and he shouted, do you sold out your soul for these trousers. And John, yes, John said, I don't understand, but you have fun for your without trousers. You're also selling something, but you sold this for money, and I did, free of charge. So it's a crash, cultural crash. How you can implement rules, governance? Do you allow to be with trousers, on trousers, sometimes with trousers? We can talk about it when we ask questions. But it's a challenge to achieve that common good. Thank you.